Have you ever wondered how utility transformers work and what is meant when somebody says primary or secondary? Let's break into it. So when you look up and there is a pole and you've got a transformer up on a pole, what we're calling primary is the primary side or first side of where the conductors come in. It's the primary circuit, you could think of it as. And then we have a secondary circuit. So the primary always comes from utility, and then the secondary goes down to a house. Now in a transformer, really all you have is a huge coil of wire. So you have one incoming conductor that goes around a coil of wire and goes back out to the other one. It doesn't touch the secondary side. So through induction, usually there's like an outer coil and then it's insulated, and on the inside there's an inner coil. So it's using the magnetic field that's generated from one side where current is flowing in the primary circuit, and it induces current to flow in the secondary circuit. It's kind of like magic, right? Like it just happens through thin air. It's one of the cool things about magnetic fields. Magnetic fields can influence electric fields, and electric fields can influence magnetic fields. So electricity, magnetism are very closely aligned, and that's why we call it electromagnetism, because they both operate very similarly. They're both of the same cloth. Essentially, magnetism is just about the spin of electrons, and electric circuits are all about the movement of electrons. So, you know, very similar kind of a thing. One more thing, we offer continuing education. Yes, we're approved in a whole bunch of different states. You can go to electricianu.com, click on the little bar on the right, go to continuing education, and we have a bunch of different states. We have more states that we're adding, so if you don't see your state, soon enough, I promise we will have it. But it's dope, you just get to watch videos of me doing this. Then we have ground, just says
the earth.
And you get credit for it. So check the link out below, hope to see you in class. So how utility power generation works is that we've got a generator at a utility company somewhere. It's essentially just a spinning magnet. That magnet is carrying mechanical energy. As that thing spins, there's mechanical energy from the magnetic field, and magnetic fields can interact with electric fields. So inside the conductors of this are electrons. And every time we spin a magnet next to a conductor, it moves those electrons. So it starts moving and it starts this pulsing back and forth in this first circuit, but it is a complete loop. This is a substation out in the field. You might see like a place where there's like a whole bunch of fenced off crazy electrical stuff in a city somewhere. That's a substation. So what they have inside of this big substation is this transformer, and a transformer is going to take that really high 150,000 volts, and it's going to transform it down into a distribution voltage. So this is a transmission voltage in a transmission circuit. This is distribution voltage, and this might go out to like several places in a neighborhood, or they might run like a whole bunch of poles and have transformers at each one of them, but it's all distribution voltage on the primary side of that transformer. So you have a primary circuit. This is what we call primary out in the field, is the entire distribution circuit on the primary side of that transformer that goes back from the utility. So all the incoming lines that you see flying overhead, that's primary. Then from there, coming down to a house or a building, that's what we call secondary. So secondary power is usually distributed down to like a 240 volt range. And then we bring conductors down into a house. We'll run like a panel, you know, somewhere in there. There's probably gonna be a meter in between it as well. There might be a switch here so that you can switch this load off, but essentially it's connecting down to another load, like a fan or like a heating element in a furnace or light bulb or something like that. But it's a complete circuit. We just put an electrical panel in between it, so we have a way of like shutting each thing off, and we have switches, circuit breakers that will turn off if too much current starts to flow. If you have a motor that's like locked up and gummed up and it won't turn, but you're sending power to it, it's gonna send so much current through the circuit. Motors, the way they work is they have to be spinning to like keep the current level down. So we put little breakers inside of here to like break things, because they can sense how much current's flowing through things. So we break that circuit or open the circuit so it's no longer energized. But when you think of an electrical service, you're thinking of all these wires going to crazy things. It's not. It's literally just wires going through the whole thing into every single one of your loads. And so there's a giant completed circuit within your house that starts from the transformer, goes through the house. So that is a secondary circuit. This is the primary circuit, and this is the even more primary circuit. I don't even know what utility company calls like sections of their service or their circuits, but I know this is the transmission portion of it. This is the distribution portion of it. And this is the premises. Premise size. That's the one. I can't spell that word right ever. Every time I write it, maintenance was always another one for me. Is it ANCE or ENCE? I don't know. Anyway, so that is how the whole thing is distributed. We are sending mechanical energy that's being generated by spinning. We're turning it into electrical energy as it passes and transforms into a different kind of energy through an electrical circuit. Then we use induction so that the movement of current in here has a magnetic field around. That invisible metal magnetic field, it starts a magnetic field in this one as all of the current starts to spin. So now we're sending energy through the distribution circuit. And then we've got the magnetic field around here that induces current flow into the magnetic field in this circuit. And that's how we get current to flow through the whole thing. So it's just sending energy around these conductors through the whole thing to the load, and it's alternating 60 times a second. That is primary and secondary. So primary, just remember, is always your incoming power from the utility company up to the transformer, and then coming out of the transformer on the side going to the house or the building, that is your secondary power. Now, the other instance, it's the exact same way, but the other instance is if you don't have a power pole and you've got one of those big green transformers out at the street, it's the exact same thing. So they just have underground power instead of have lines going through the neighborhood. They've got underground power that goes in and hooks to the primary side of that transformer. They've got a secondary side of the transformer that's doing the same thing, going straight to the house. So they work the exact same way. It's just that running underground power is not as common because overhead's just like easier and cheaper to do. Underground, you gotta like dig trenches. You might have to core drill, like drill underground for a really long distance. And it's like heavy equipment and a lot of time laying all that stuff out and then trying to pull conductors through all the conduit. Whereas overhead, they could just go like bore holes in the earth and drop poles and pull wire across them. Like it's a lot easier. So usually in like really fancy neighborhoods that, you know, they don't want to have all these lines coming everywhere, you're going to see a lot of underground pad mounted transformers everywhere. So that's the whole primary secondary thing. That's how electrical services work. That's how power is generated. I think that's it. So leave some comments below. Let me know if there's anything else about that you want explained a little bit more. Love you crazy people. I'll see you in the next one.